Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. My name is Sarah. In today's video, I would like to show you everything that I made during the winter season, which I'm counting from about the end of December to now the beginning of March. And I'm cutting it off there because I have a big spring project coming up that I will be sharing with you very soon. But today I have 8 finished garments that I sewed to share with you today, as well as 1 finished knitting project and 1 knitting project that I haven't quite finished, that I probably won't finish, and that I'm a little bit puzzled as to how to proceed, and so I'd like your help. But I will get to that very soon. So get comfortable, grab a beverage of your choice. This video is probably not going to be very long, but I'll try and keep it short each project, but I have 10 projects to share with you, so let's get right to it. The first project that I would like to share with you today is the Sew Over It Estelle dress that I made in this really beautiful dark green velvet fabric that I found at Tissu ML, which is a German fabric shop. And I say it in French because they have a French version of their website for French customers. And I just love this fabric. It's really soft and stretchy and this really beautiful jewel-toned green. And I was very curious about working with stretch velvet because I'd never worked with it before. And it was somewhat difficult because it's very slinky and stretchy. It did sort of stretch out under my machine. But I used a lighter jersey needle and then I used my walking foot as well. And as soon as I put the walking foot on the machine, everything went much better. I think it only stretched out a little bit, maybe along the belt here, the waist high, but other than that, I think that it sewed up pretty well. I made a size 6 graded to a size 8 at the hips all the way down to the hem, and then I shortened the hem about 17 centimeters because I wanted the length to be just below the knee instead of midi length like the pattern was originally designed to be. I think that I should have probably left 5 centimeters more, just about, because this fabric is 100% polyester, and so when I'm standing still it doesn't ride up, but when I'm walking it does stick to my legs and ride up a little bit, even if I wear a half slip underneath to keep it from sticking to my tights. So that's a little bit of a shame. I think that I don't really like when it rides up above my knees. I don't find that length very flattering. It's not a big deal though, and I am still pretty happy with this project. I actually made this for a New Year's party that I was invited to at the end of the year, but I ended up not being able to go because I came down with a really bad head cold. Nothing serious, but pretty annoying. And I did finish it in time for the New Year's celebrations at home. And it was pretty comfortable to wear, even sick. It's not constraining in any way because it is very, very stretchy. And I love the shape of this dress. I like the neckline. I think it's very flattering. And the 3/4 length sleeves and the waist tie. I find the construction of the pattern really interesting because I've never really made a pattern like that before. And so yeah, I think it was interesting to make and interesting to wear. And I can't wait to wear it again at the holidays this year, at the end of this year, because it is a little bit too formal for an everyday sort of use. It'll just have to come out and I'll have to wear it at the holiday season this year. The next 3 projects are actually projects that I did in collaboration with Minerva, which is a fabric shop in the UK, and they sent me these fabrics for free in exchange for an article on their website, and so I will link those articles down below if you'd like to go check them out in detail. But the first one is this Sew Over It Erin skirt from their City Break ebook that was published a few years ago in this really beautiful sapphire colored basket weave cotton canvas. And this fabric is originally really meant to be for upholstery or bags, so a backpack or a tote bag would look great in this fabric, but I absolutely love the color, and it was specified that it's a softer touch, and it is. It's not as rough on the outside as you might think for a basket weave cotton canvas. And so I decided to make this skirt because the skirt is meant for jean fabrics, so tougher, thicker fabrics, and I thought that it would work well even if it doesn't have any stretch because the pattern doesn't call for any stretch. It's just nice for a little extra ease. And I have originally made this pattern once before in a dark wash jean fabric with a little bit of stretch, and I do recommend that if you do make this pattern. And I wanted to make it again because I had originally shortened it to just above the knee with my first Erin skirt, and I wanted to try the original length, which is just below the knee, because I'm much more comfortable with that style now. And also, the smallest size of this pattern is a size 8 rather than their new pattern size range, which goes to a size 6, which corresponds to my bust and waist measurements. And so I ended up manually grading this pattern down at the waist, 1 hypothetical size down, and then grading that line to a size 8 at the hips, and then keeping with the 8 down to the hem. And I really like the way that this turned out. I think that I had made that modification originally with the pattern when I first made it, but that was one of my very first sewing projects, so I wanted to try grading again because I think that I've improved over time, and I think that I was able to make that line a bit smoother. And I think that this project is a success. To be honest, I haven't really worn it yet because I find that the sapphire color, I love looking at it, but I don't really want to wear it. I think maybe when the weather warms up and the lighting changes to less of a really cold white light to a little bit warmer and brighter colors, and maybe I'll want to wear it a little bit more. But for now, I don't really reach for it, and that's a little bit of a shame. But I do love the way it looks. I think the fit is great. I really love this pattern. It's pretty easy to put together as well. There are darts and buttonholes, but it's pretty simple and it comes together pretty quickly. So I highly recommend this pattern as well. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with this project. The next project was actually a bit of a disaster that I ended up fixing and making work, but it took a long time. And it was this Berlin skirt by French pattern maker Orageuse Patterns. I love the shape of this skirt. I've made it once before in a gray polyester, but when I made it before, I remember thinking never again, and I couldn't remember why. Now I know why. And I have made notes. So I decided to make it in this Minerva Core Range herringbone polyester fabric. It is a suiting fabric, and it's got this really lovely sort of chevron pattern to it. I think it's really beautiful, and it's light, and it holds a pleat, but it doesn't hold a wrinkle, which is great. So it's a lovely fabric, and I decided to make this skirt because I love the lines. But basically, I made a size 34 graded to a size 36 at the hips, and when I tried it on, when I inserted the zip and tried it on, I couldn't get it over my hips, and it wasn't the shell fabric that was blocking, it was the lining. And all of a sudden, it came back to me why I didn't line the last version that I made, and it's because the lining doesn't work. It's too small. It's almost as though the seam allowances weren't included in the lining pieces, even though the instructions indicate that they are. And I just couldn't fit it over my hips, and I double-checked the sizes. It was definitely the right size. I didn't make any mistakes cutting out the pattern or cutting out the fabric, and so I ended up having to fiddle with the fit quite a lot. So what I did was I took out the side seams and the center back seam, and it was kind of hard because the seam allowances were already only 1 centimeter, and so I ended up sewing them at 0.5 centimeter to get back a centimeter of ease at the hips and also at the center back. And that worked for the shell fabric to make it a little bit looser and to stop it from distorting the pleats in the front, but the lining fabric was still too tight and it just fit over my hips. And so I ended up actually inserting strips of lining along the center back seam and sewing it to the side backs, and for a total of 6 centimeters of added fabric inside the skirt, which is just ridiculous. But now it fits. Now I can put it on and it doesn't pull at my hips and it hangs correctly. But it took just hours. I ended up unpicking and re-sewing the zip at least twice. And it was just much more complicated than it had to be. So beware. If you want to try this pattern, definitely add more ease to it, especially to the lining pieces. I think the lining pieces just weren't drafted correctly. And it seems to be that this experience was shared. I shared this on Instagram and a lot of people got back to me saying that they had the same problem, so I don't think it was me. But I am happy with the way it turned out. I'm glad that I persevered. I didn't want to throw it out and throw out the fabric with it. I like the length, the below the knee length, and I like the front split of the skirt. I think it's really flattering. I like the sort of slanted Italian pockets at the side and the pleat and the belt. I just think it's really elegant and it's such a shame. Although, do be careful when you're sitting down in this one. The slit does sort of ride up, and so you have to be very careful if you don't want to expose yourself in this skirt. But yeah, I think that this pattern went pretty well in the end, or worked out pretty well, and I'm happy with it now. The last product I made in collaboration with Minerva was this B6453 dress, or Butterick dress, that I made in the second version, I think, with the gathered skirt in this really beautiful viscose chelis in this black and white polka dotted fabric. And the drape on this fabric is just absolutely beautiful. Can you hear it? Oh, it's just so lovely. And I think it's definitely not very wintry, but it'll definitely come into use in the spring, and I think I can layer it with a sweater or tights to wear it in early spring, and so I'm really excited. I made the size 6 of this dress, and I've made this dress a few times before. So once before with the gathered skirt, although the hem was just above the knee when I hemmed it. I don't know if that was a choice that I made or the pattern. And so this time, because I wanted to go below the knee or finish below the knee, I lengthened the pattern about 10 inches just to have wiggle room. I think in the end, I ended up taking about 2 to 3 inches off while I was hemming it. So maybe 7 inches total. And I really love the length now. I think it looks really nice. And then I've also made the straight skirt version a few times. And so I'm used to making the bodice, and I have modified the bodice a little bit a long time ago, and I followed those same modifications this time. So from what I see on the pattern, I took in the side seams and a little bit of the center front princess seams along the bust. And yeah, I think that the fit is pretty good. I think that it is a little bit loose right now in this viscose in this version. So I might eventually take in the side seams a little bit, but I don't think it's too visible. I don't think it's hanging too much. I think that it works, and it just has a little extra ease for me for sitting down and moving around. So in the end, I don't think it's a big problem. I modified this pattern in a few other ways as well. I inserted an invisible zip rather than a regular zip, and then I fully lined the bodice part or top half of the pattern rather than using the facings. And to do that, I just cut out the front and back pieces again out of my lining fabric, which is a black viscose that I had in my fabric stash. And so yeah, it worked out pretty well that way. And I'm really happy with the way this turned out. It's very swishy. I think the polka dot black and white will work with a lot of different clothes in my wardrobe, and it's a classic. So it's something that I'll be able to wear quite often. And yeah, I'm really happy with this one. The next project I would like to show you was somewhat of a feat or a challenge, and I'm really happy that I got it done. And it is these Sew Over It Luna pajamas that I made in this really beautiful cotton flannel. It's 100% cotton, and I found it at Hobby Lobby when I went to Connecticut in the fall to go visit friends. And I was really excited to find this flannel because I've never really worked with flannel before. It's not something you find easily in France. Or in Europe in general. And I wanted to make this pattern because it is interesting in the design, in that it's more of a straight leg design, and it doesn't have an outer seam along the leg. It just has an inseam, which makes it easier for pattern matching, which I succeeded in doing here. So basically what happened with this fabric is I bought it in yards, and I'm not used to buying fabric in yards. I'm used to buying fabric in meters, and I didn't realize how very narrow the fabric was. And so I ended up not having enough fabric to get both the top and the pants easily out of. And so I prioritized making the pants first, and I like the way that they turned out. I think that the rise is very comfortable. It's not too tight, not too baggy. Same for the pant legs. It's a straight cut. It's not too baggy, not too tight. And I like the length. And it's just really, really comfortable. I've been wearing it almost nonstop since I finished making them about 6 weeks ago. But then once I finished making the pants, I had about a yard left and scraps. And I thought, oh, I don't want to just put this away and have it languish in the attic for the next few years. What am I gonna do with a yard of flannel? And so I decided to try and make the top. So I spent an entire evening with the fabric laid out on the floor and trying to fit the pattern pieces, like puzzle pieces, onto the fabric, and trying to get as many seams as possible to pattern match along the edges so that the check wouldn't be completely wonky. And I ended up modifying the pattern quite a bit to get it to fit. So with the pants, I made a size 8, which corresponds to my hips. And with the top, I wanted to make a size 6, graded to a size 8 at the high hips, just for extra ease. But in the end, I ended up just cutting a size 6. Because my high hips are sort of in between a size 6 and a size 8, I figured it would fit, and it kind of ends at the high hips and not down at the hips, so it'd be fine. And then I also shortened the seam allowance at the hem to, I think, about a centimeter, so a very small one. And then I also shortened the sleeves to 3/4 lengths instead of long. And and then I also turned one of the sleeves so perpendicular to the grain line rather than parallel, because it just didn't fit otherwise. And so far, even though you're not supposed to do that, so far I don't feel the difference, and I think it works fine. So in the end, I was able to get the top out of this fabric, and I was able to even pattern match along the side seams, which I am just so happy about. And I was even able to piece together the waistband or the waist tie out of, I think, 4 different pieces of flannel. And in the end, I had basically no fabric left, just teeny tiny little scraps, which was incredibly satisfying. And so I'm very happy I got this out. I think the top is pretty comfortable. I don't actually wear the top very much. I think that for pajamas, I've discovered that I much prefer very loose, sort of stretchy fabrics on my arms and kind of enveloping me, and not so much sort of stiff fabrics, but it does keep me pretty warm, and I love the pajama pants, and I'm very happy with the way that this project turned out. The next two projects are actually the same pattern, and it is the Sew Over It Heather dress in these double knit fabrics in a sort of bluish heather gray and this black fabric. And this fabric is actually something that I've been using quite a lot. You've probably seen it in some of my previous videos a few times in a few different colors. And it's because it's this really cozy, sort of soft and very stretchy double knit. And the content is more viscose than it is polyester, which is very rare. I haven't found that very often, and I just love that. And so I've been working with this fabric quite a lot, and I wanted to make a gray version of the heather dress. So if you saw my sweater dress video, you know that I have 6 heather dresses already, and that is one of my favorite sweater dress patterns, and it's something I sort of make at least 1 a year in the winter colder seasons. And so I wanted to make it out of this gray fabric, and then I also wanted to make it in a black fabric because I have a black version already, but it's getting kind of ratty. It's 6 years old, so it's kind of normal that it's getting sort of used looking. And I wanted to make it out of this really beautiful fabric. But I also wanted, with this pattern, so when I first made it, it was only available in a size 8 as the smallest pattern size, which corresponds to my hip, but not to my waist and my bust. And so originally I had sized down the heather pattern quite a lot. I had sort of taken out a whole bunch of ease in the side seams, and then I'd also had to add a center back seam because it was way too much fabric pooling in my lower back. I found that it was a little bit unfortunate because it's already paneled in the front and the back, and so there were the paneling seam allowances and then also the center back seam, and just 3 seams like that, it was just kind of very choppy and not very elegant. And so I wanted to try making it with their new pattern size range, because they re-released this pattern in their extended size range, including the size 6, which corresponds to my bust and my waist. And so I wanted to re-grade the pattern, so grade it from a size 6 to a size 8 at the hips, and see if that worked better, and also eliminated some of the center back excess fabric pooling that I had, without having a center back seam. And so I tried it out. I made the gray version first, and I made sure to check the side seams before sewing it up, because with these knit fabrics, I use a lightning stitch, and it's called, I think in the Love to Sew podcast, they called it a stitch of doom, or a listener called in and called it a stitch of doom, which I completely agree with. It is impossible to unpick a lightning stitch without also ruining your fabric. And so I basted the side seams first and checked the fit in the mirror before sewing it up permanently, and it looked like it was good. So I sewed it up that way, and I'm pretty excited about the results. I think that it fits pretty well. I don't need to add a center back seam anymore. And yeah, I'm really happy with the fit. Although I do think that there's a little bit of extra or too much ease at the hips and the hem. Because this fabric's very much drapier than the regular double knit fabric, it's not as stiff as a polyester double knit, and so you can see that excess a lot more, and it just kind of fits more casually like a t-shirt dress, and I'd like it to be a little bit slimmer, at least for the black version that I wear to work, for example. I think I will take out some of that extra ease in the hips and the hem, or down to the hem, to make it a little bit slimmer. And I think because this fabric is so stretchy, I don't risk taking out too much. I probably would only take out maybe a centimeter or so anyway. But yeah, I'm really happy with these. They're very comfortable, very cozy, and I highly recommend this pattern. I think that I will be using this new pattern a lot in the future. My last sewing project was more of a palette cleanser sort of impulse sew, which I made in about a day because it's an easy pattern to make, and it is the Sew Over It Edie top from their Work to Weekend ebook, I think. And I made it in a size 8 because that's the smallest size available, even though I should be making a size 6 and like grading it down manually. The neckline does sort of gape open on me, and it is a little bit drapey for me around the waist and the hips, but it's okay because I mostly wear this top I like to make it in very drapey fabrics, and I mostly wear it to sleep in, and so it's not a big deal if it's a little bit extra gapey on me. And this is a sea green modal or tencel, I think it's modal viscose from Tissu MR, and that's also where I got the double knit fabric for the two heather dresses previously as well. And so I made this in about a day. It's very easy, it's a very quick sew. The only thing is that this fabric is very difficult to sew with because it's the kind of fabric that my machine likes to eat. And by eat, I mean it pulls it into the needle plate and chews on it into a little ball, and it's hard to rip it out without ripping the fabric. And so what I did in addition to using a fine jersey needle and a walking foot is I used some tissue paper at the very start of the seam every time, just kind of behind the fabric and underneath the underneath the fabric, touching the plate so that it would glide a little bit better. And that worked pretty well because after you just rip off the paper and it's fine. And I think it turned out pretty well. I wear this already all the time. I'm very happy with it, and I highly recommend this pattern. So those are all of my sewing makes that I made this winter season. This is my knitting project that I finished. Let me show you this edge. This is the sophomore shawl by Two of Wands, and it's in this Hue and Me yarn by Lion Brand in the Rosewater colorway, and it's the same colorway as the pattern photos, so I wanted to try making it. I thought the color was really beautiful, and in the end I think the color is really beautiful. I like it a lot. I really like this waffle stitch as well. I think it's really interesting, and I wanted to try making it because I love making texture with the knit fabrics that I make. I mean, contrasted with just the simple stockinette stitch, I think it's really beautiful. This knitted up pretty quickly, I think, because it's a bulkier yarn and larger size needles. I forget which size, but it was very satisfying because once you get into the rhythm of knitting it, it went pretty easily, and the fabric was created pretty quickly, and so that was nice. But I find that it was a little bit harder for me to knit with because it was a little bit sticky. The content is 80% acrylic and 20% wool, and so it can be washed by machine and dried as well. But I found it to be really sticky on my needles, and I'm using wooden needles, so that probably added to it. I think with metal needles it would be not as sticky, a little bit, yeah, maybe more slippery. But I found that it was very tough, and I was experiencing some wrist pain, especially with the increasing stitches. And so it wasn't the most enjoyable knitting project. I probably wouldn't knit with this yarn again, but I'm really happy with the way that this turned out. It is very bulky. I've tried fitting it underneath my coats and over it, but I find that it doesn't fit underneath, and then over it limits my head movements because it's so bulky. So I don't think I'll be wearing it as a scarf out of the house. I think I'll be wearing it more as a shawl in the house when I'm just relaxing or around in the cooler season. And so far I've been wearing it pretty happily. It's kind of stretchy, it fits over my shoulders really nicely, and it stays because it stretches over my shoulders. And yeah, I'm really happy with this one. I highly recommend this pattern. It was pretty nice to sew and pretty easy. And yeah, I'm happy with this. The knit project I mentioned in the beginning that I will probably be not finishing is actually the Discon sweater that I was knitting. It is by Durham Natura's artist, Soden Kualoye, I think her name is. And it is this really beautiful pattern. I was using the Durham Natura Robinson yarn in the Mascari colorway. And basically the problem with this one is I think my gauge is right. It is a little bit looser than my swatch. I created a pretty big swatch in the round before knitting this or before starting, and my swatch was engaged. So I think that once I block it, it would be. But basically, it is huge on me. I think the ease originally planned for this sweater is about 10 centimeters for my bust size. And I was already making the smallest size because this is something I've encountered in knitting that's really frustrating me, is that the smallest size is typically just about too big for me, like it's the maximum amount of ease. And so I don't have a lot of flexibility to choose a size down or go down sizes to kind of manipulate the ease. I'm always in the category of the most amount of ease. And I don't know how to modify knit patterns yet to make smaller sizes, so it's very frustrating. But basically, I think that because the fabric created with this design, even though the texture is really beautiful, it sort of stiffens the fabric and it doesn't drape as well, and so it sort of poofs out at the belly and the sides. And then because the ribbing is a little bit smaller and sits a little bit closer to my body, it sort of blouses out over the ribbing. and it's just really unflattering. It's just really lumpy. And so I don't like the way that it sits on me. I don't like all the excess fabric. I think if I block it, it will reduce some of this excess, but I think it's still going to be too much because now that I look at the pattern photos, I see that that's sort of in the design, that it's sort of more sweatshirty in the way it hangs, and it's just not really my style. And it's just such a shame because I think if it had a little bit more shaping and it wasn't so boxy, maybe it would sit better. And I really love this design and this fabric that it creates. But yeah, I think I would never wear it. I don't think it'd be very flattering on me. I already tried tucking it in and sort of wearing it different ways, but even if it looks okay in the front, it's super bulky on the side and in the back. And so yeah, I'm gonna be unraveling this, I think, and making something else, but I'm not entirely sure what I can make with this yarn. So if you have any suggestions, I've been looking a lot on Ravelry and filtering by yarn type, but I'm lost. So if you have any ideas that pop into mind, let me know what to do with this, because it's just really beautiful. I like the slightly marled color you get with it and the fabric, and yeah, I'd like to put this to good use. So yeah, that's what I'll be doing with this one. It's a bit of a shame, but oh well. So those are all of the projects that I made this winter season, and oof, there were a lot of them. So if you're still here, congratulations. I will make sure to link all of the patterns I discussed in the description below, so don't hesitate to check those out. And let me know which one is your favorite of my makes. I won't take offense. I think my favorite is probably between the polka dot dress and the lunar pajamas, probably the lunar pajamas, because that check matching made me very proud. And I have been wearing those pajama pants just nonstop since I made them. So yeah, I think that's my favorite. I hope that you are all doing well, and I will see you again here very soon with a new video. Take care, and bye-bye.